On this channel, we often talk about leaks, we talk about data mines, unofficial information. The channel is about covering Battlefield 2 its fullest, so anyone who lands here is going to get the latest details. Today, we're definitely talking about unofficial information because it's already been confirmed by the person who posted it that it's not true. But nevertheless, the post actually got me thinking about the future of Battlefield 5, very specifically what we can really expect and what the community can expect from the game. In this video today, I'm going to work through what I think is an ideal future for Battlefield 5, in my opinion, and I'm also going to go through the post as well because I think it's kind of along the right track. I'd like to see some of your comments down below in the comments section too. Let me know what you're thinking. But just before we get into that, a word from our sponsor today, Elgato Gaming. They've just announced their brand new 4K 60 Pro Mark II internal capture card. It's half the size of the original card, and it now supports HDR10 capture at 4K 60 resolution and frame rate, while simultaneously being able to stream to your site of choice at 1080p 60. Your bitrate can be cranked right up to 140 megabits per second, which is higher than that of a Blu-ray disc. You're getting insanely high quality recording right there. So for more details or any more information, click the link at the top of the description and head over to the Elgato website. Right then, on with the video. First of all, we'll look at this Reddit post. As I've said already, it has been confirmed as a joke by the original poster, which completely removes any need for you to take your standard pinch of salt when talking about unofficial information, but it does display what I think is a kind of realistic version for the future of Battlefield 5, despite being completely false. Things are stretched a little bit too far in some of the parts we're going to talk about, but on the whole, the post would have fooled me into thinking it might have been somewhat legitimate if the poster hadn't confirmed it was a fake. First of all, the thread comments on the holiday taken by the developers at DICE during July and August. This is very much a true statement. Lots of the development team did take holiday during July, as is almost tradition in Sweden, as I'm learning. People take their time off when there's most sunlight in that country, and a lot of businesses almost shut down during the month of July. DICE is really no different, and this happens almost every year. Next, the post talks about update 4.4, which is set to go live apparently on September the 5th, this coming Thursday. That date isn't official yet, but it may well indeed become true. The 4.4 patch was delayed into early September due to some bugs found when compiling the patch for certification. Now, this patch also contains the two close quarter maps that we saw at Gamescom, Lofoten Islands and Provence. Both were due to launch in August, but have since missed that deadline. Now, the post also claims the long-awaited Alcindam map is going to launch with the 4.4 patch as well, alongside support for a grand operation that's set to bring the Mercury and Marita maps together for a Battle of Greece kind of setup. Now, I think that's kind of a stretch, both on the Alcindam front and the Battle of Greece grand operation. Alcindam is a very hot topic within the community right now, and if it were coming in a patch, I think DICE would make more noise about it. It would be a positive step forward for them to deliver the map after such a long delay. We are now into the third month that it's being delayed now, so if it was coming in this patch, I think they would have said something a little bit sooner. As for the Greek grand operation, I can't actually find any official confirmation that this is coming to the game. I think this has been created by the community along the way somewhere. I did manage to find a Datamine Reddit post from Tempor Yao, which brought up data that suggested one was being planned, but beyond that, I have nothing official here. And of course, just because these things are data mined, that doesn't actually mean they'll end up coming to the game. I'm looking at you, cancelled 5v5 mode. The post goes on to state that Operation Underground, the reimagined Operation Metro map, that's going to launch in the last week of Chapter 4, going live on September the 12th. Now, I don't think that this date is correct, but the post may have in fact correctly predicted the month of launch. Previously, this reimagined Metro map was slated to release in October, between Chapters 4 and 5, and that was confirmed in the Chapter 4 trailer. But in a statement the other week, it was confirmed that Operation Underground would arrive with patch 4.6, and that's currently slated to arrive in September. It's likely to be late September, as with almost every monthly Battlefield 5 patch, but that's September nonetheless. And if that does turn out to be true, it'd be a nice surprise for the Battlefield community, and I think it's going to give players a little bit more time with the map before the Pacific chapter takes over the month after. And hey, it'd be nice if a map did release early instead of being delayed or cancelled completely. Then, moving on to the Pacific chapter, Chapter 5, apparently that's going to launch on September the 26th, and it's going to come with 6 new maps playable on Conquest and Breakthrough. This is another one of those stretches that this post has made so far. We've been told that by DICE and EA that 3 new maps will be launching before the end of 2019, so the idea that 6 would launch with the new chapter does look a little bit ridiculous. The poster is also claiming that 3 new grand operations would launch with the chapter as well, and I think, yeah, this is definitely a mistake considering how poorly the grand operation structure was received by the community when the game launched. Before adding any more grand operations, I think DICE would need to rework or simply rewind grand operations to its Battlefield 1 setup, where they string the maps into a narrative and then just focus purely on the breakthrough game mode, taking maps sector by sector. I don't think we're going to see 6 Pacific maps launching at the end of September. I don't even think the launch date of September 26th is anywhere near correct. Beyond that, the post claimed that an additional 2 maps are in development for after the Pacific chapter already, which may well be true considering how long it takes to produce maps for Battlefield games. You're looking at a minimum of 6 months, really, extending up to about 10 months to completely make a map. I'd wager that the development team would be in the early to mid stages with maps coming in 2020 at this point. And then the final part claims that chapters 6 and 7 have been locked in with budget, and working titles are Eastern Front and Downfall respectively. As much as we are a long way from those chapters at the moment, I don't think anyone would really go against a chapter bringing the Eastern Front into the game, likely bringing the USSR into the conflict. As I've said, this is completely false, but if that did happen, I don't think anyone would really be complaining. So that's the story of the post on Reddit, which is completely made up. But I think it paints a similar picture to my ideal future and somewhat more realistic future for Battlefield 5. First of all, bringing Operation Underground to the game in September, that is going to give players new content a little bit sooner than expected, which will certainly be welcome considering all the delays and cancellations that we've experienced for the game for the last few months. I don't think we're going to be seeing Alcindan this week in Update 4.4, despite how awesome that would be. I'm expecting it to arrive in Update 4.6 alongside the Operation Underground map. A double map drop at the end of September, that would be really good. One focusing on infantry combat, and the other, the proper combined arms, all-out warfare, ground vehicles, air battles, and infantry with Alcindan. Having both of those side by side would be a really good update to the game. Then moving into the Pacific chapter, so far, as I mentioned, we know 3 maps will launch before the end of 2019. One of them is Iwo Jima, and I fully expect one to release every single month. One in late October, with the beginning of the new chapter, one in November, and then one in December. If that were to happen, one per month, it'd give people enough time to play the map properly, experience it properly, before it was taken over by another one. We know that boats are going to be coming with that update as well, along with plenty of new weapons for the American and Japanese factions, new cosmetics, new vehicles. The game is going to see a complete shift to a new theater of war, so I expect the entire game is going to change a bit from that point onwards. Moving into 2020, I think DICE might slightly extend the Pacific chapter into like January and February, maybe adding another map or two. That would be really cool, and this is based on the fact that the roadmap says that 3 maps will be delivered before the end of 2019. It just seems like a very specific statement to say 3 maps before the end of 2019. So what's coming in 2020. I'm sure that's been left out of the roadmap for various business reasons, but maybe having a little bit of an extension of the Pacific into the early months of 2020 would be the right thing to do. Having 4 or 5 maps in total for the Pacific would really signal to players that the game was moving in the right direction, and I think it would help everybody move past a very miserable 2019 for Battlefield players. Either the game was broken, it was lacking content, or content was delayed. 2019 has been a really bad year for Battlefield, and specifically Battlefield 5, so maybe the Pacific could be a way to get everyone away from that and onto something different. Moving further into 2020, after the Pacific, I think DICE pivoting over to the Eastern Front of the War would be the best move, introducing some completely different battlefields and obviously bringing the USSR into the mix. The Eastern Front was massive during World War II. It featured huge levels of vehicle combat as well. That could massively change up the theme of the game for a few months. I think DICE would need to do exactly what they're planning to do with the Pacific for the Eastern Front. We'd need to see lots of new maps, vehicles, the USSR faction, cosmetics to go with that, weapons, the works. That'd be something I'd love to see happen in sort of mid-2020. And then further beyond that, well, I'd assume we're closing in on the end of World War II by that point, so perhaps recreating the D-Day landings, Operation Dragoon as well in the south of France, perhaps depicting the pushback of the Germans towards Berlin. That would make for a really interesting conclusion to Battlefield 5 before whatever game DICE is working on next is announced or released. We still don't have any idea when the next Battlefield game is coming. Is it 2020? Is it 2021? Is it modern? Is it historic? We just don't know. So a really big final push for Battlefield 5, the race to Berlin or something like that, that could be really cool. In general, DICE has a huge amount of work to do with Battlefield 5, not only to make the game good, but also to repair the damage that they've done with the community around the game. There's still a lot of people who pay attention to what's happening with Battlefield 5, and I know a lot of people are simply waiting for the right time for them to jump back into the action. I think that climb back upwards in reputation, that starts with update 4.6 at the end of September, when we know Operation Underground is going to hit the game. At that point, I think people will sit up and they will pay more attention. And it's at that point that the game will have new ranks to grind, hopefully we'll have rental servers as well, and we'll be on the brink of Pacific content hitting the game in a month or so's time. It could be a real turning point, and yes, I know I've said there have been turning points before, but this one with the Pacific or the end of Chapter 4, that could be absolutely massive. And I really hope it is. But there you go. Thanks for watching today. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments section, and make sure you stay up to date with the Battlefield 5 news and information. Things are going to start hotting up for this game. There's a lot of content on the horizon before the end of 2019, so make sure you've hit that subscribe button and then the bell icon. Turn on notifications, and that way you won't miss any of my videos. But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.